One and all. Today we are going to deal with the topic dental auxiliaries. It is other side named as dental ancillaries also. These are the following contents: introduction, definition, degree of supervisions, and classification of auxiliaries. They are classified into non-operating auxiliaries as dental surgery assistant, dental secretary or receptionist, dental laboratory technician, and dental health educator. In the first session, we will be dealing regarding the non-operating auxiliaries. In the second session, we will be dealing with the operating auxiliaries. They are school dental nurse, dental therapist, dental hygienist, and expanded functions of dental offices. And there are other newer type of auxiliaries. They are dental licensate and dental aide. And conclusion. Coming to introduction, the necessity to develop the role of ancillaries in private practice and in public health programs is no longer a question of debate. As if we are planning not only for a prevention program, there might be a reparative treatment that is required. There is indeed the increasing demands in the healthcare if the population grows from present to higher. If the dentists are only the persons who have been trained, it becomes a lack of time also. So, under his supervision, there are some people who can do the service of dental field. Definition: a dental auxiliary can be defined as a person who is given responsibilities by a dentist so that he or she can help the dentist render dental care, but who is not himself or herself qualified with a dental degree. So he is being responsible by the dentist who guides them. According to the degree of supervision of auxiliaries, American Dental Association in 1975 defined 4 degrees of supervision of auxiliaries with the assumption that ultimate responsibility was assumed by the licensed dentist. That is, one is general supervision. The dentist has authorized the procedures and they are being carried out in accordance with the diagnosis and the treatment plan. The second one is indirect supervision. The dentist is in the dental office, authorizes the procedure and remains in the dental office while the procedures are being performed by the auxiliary. Direct supervision. The dentist is in the dental office, personally diagnoses the conditions to be treated, personally authorizes the procedures, and before dismissal of the patient, evaluate the performance of the dental auxiliary. And the fourth one is personal supervision. The dentist is personally operating on a patient and authorizes the auxiliary to aid treatment by concurrently performing supportive procedures. These are the 4 types of supervision according to American Dental Association, which was given to the dentist as if he is the person who guides the auxiliaries. According to WHO classification, there are 2 types of auxiliaries. One is non-operating auxiliary and the second one is operating auxiliary. In the non-operating auxiliaries, they are being defined as clinical and laboratory. In clinical, a person who assists the dentist in his clinical work but does not carry out any independent procedures in the oral cavity. The second one in non-operating auxiliaries is laboratory. A person who assists the professional, that is the dentist, by carrying out certain technical laboratory procedures. And the second one in classification is operating auxiliaries. This is a person who, not being a professional, is permitted to carry out certain treatment procedures in the mouth under the direction and supervision of a professional. The classification in particular is useful to draw the distinction between the operating and the non-operating auxiliaries. However, the use of the term auxiliary is unfortunate since this is sometimes used loosely or specifically to describe workers with defined tasks. The more embracing term ancillary would be more satisfactory. So, the classification has been revised. Revised classification states two classes. They are non-operating ancillaries and operating ancillaries. In the non-operating ancillaries, they are classified into dental surgery assistant, dental secretary or receptionist, dental laboratory technician, and dental health educator. And in the operating ancillaries, they are being classified into school dental nurse, dental therapist, dental hygienist, and expanded functions of dental auxiliaries. The first in the non-operating auxiliary is the dental surgery assistant. It was first in 1885, Dr. C. Edmund Kells in the New Orleans put up a woman in his office and he named as the office as the lady in attendance. So she helps the dentist in not only in the chair side but in the business office also. Then she performs the non-technical work that do not require any or much training so that dentists can concentrate and devote full attention to care the patient. The duties are. The first one in the duties might be the reception of the patient, preparation of the patient for any treatments, preparation and provision of all necessary facilities such as mouthwashes, napkins to the patients. Sterilization care, preparation of instruments, patient instructions, preparation of surgery for the next patient, mixing materials and after treatment patient care. Presentation of documents, assistant with x-ray and aftercare of general anesthesia patients. These are most of the duties that can be performed by the dental surgery assistant. The second one in the non-operating auxiliaries is the dental secretary or receptionist. She assists the dentist with his secretarial work and the patient reception duties. And the third one is dental laboratory technician. Dental laboratory technician is a non-operating auxiliary who fulfills the prescriptions provided by the dentist regarding the extra oral construction and repair of the oral appliances and bridgework. The duties are casting of models from impressions made by the dentist, fabrication of dentures, splints, orthodontic appliances, inlays, crowns, and also special trays. Dentist. It is the term applied by the dental laboratory technician who is permitted to fabricate dentures directly for patients without the prescription of the dentist. According to ADA, that is American Dental Association, define denturism as the fitting and dispensing of the dentures illegally to the public. As if in 1959, the WHO expert committee of the auxiliary dental personnel has recommended that the dentist who has been qualified may work on the patients directly. So it was opposed by the American Dental Association. But in some countries like Tasmania in Australia and the Denmark has given permission for the persons of the laboratory technicians and named them as dentists who can perform and prepare the dentures and give it to the patients directly. And also in some countries like the Greece and the European countries also has given the permission for giving the dentures directly by the laboratory technician. So they have been named as denturists. The last is the dental health educator. In few countries, the duties of some dental health surgery assistants have been extended to allow them to carry out certain preventive procedures. Thus, in Sweden, 2 additional weeks of training was given after the ancillaries to conduct the fluoride mouth rinsing programs to the school children. So these are the persons who instructs in the prevention of the dental diseases and who may also be permitted to apply the preventive agents intraorally. So by this we will conclude the chapter of non-operating auxiliaries in the first session. Thank you.